สวัสดีค่ะ. My name is Kotchakorn Voraakhom. I'm a landscape architect from Bangkok, Thailand. My calling in life is to make my city more resilient to climate change. Did you know that my city, Bangkok, is actually sinking more than 1 centimeter per year, which is 4 times faster than the rate of predicted sea level rise?
I won a design competition to build Bangkok's first new public park in over 30 years. The park became a space for people to walk and exercise, but also it is helping city deal with its water. Built on a slope, the park captures rain and store it for later use.
But you don't need to build a big project like mine. We can actually help our city to be more greener and more sustainable through our lifestyle. So here I am to share my 5 top tips to you. Here is the paradox created by climate change. It's either too much of water or too little of the water. With too much of the water, it actually can create immediate disaster to my city.
In paved Bangkok, only 15 minutes of rainfall can turn our city in chaos through traffic. We need to catch and keep this pouring rain so that it doesn't flood everywhere. One of the easiest ways to do this is to replace concrete with garden wherever we can. It's not only look nicer and greener, it's also help catch more of the excess rain water.
At home, we can actually restore an excess water into the rainwater tank, which can restore and later use in our daily activities. One of the most wasted space in our city is the roof space, and we can turn that to benefit us in many ways, like growing food.
I used this idea in one of my projects, turning the concrete roof in a university into a rooftop farm, which is now the largest one in Asia.
Imagine if the whole city can use this concept, we are actually better off fixing our food security problem and actually have an organic food right close to our home. I know many of you love gardening, landscaping, but let me tell you, some of those exotic plants that we use in our garden can be invasive species, and that's not helping our urban environment.
It is much better for pollinators like bees and other insects or even little birds if we stick to native plants, those that naturally grow where we live, and let our garden be a little messy. You will save more time not to having to trim your lawn as often, but it's even better, you actually encourage biodiversity.
So you can actually do it in your garden or even your balcony. It has been said many times that we humans produce too much waste. We need to find the best way to bring back those waste, those rubbish back into our life. Recycle, upcycle, or any circular process that we can create. For me, I recycle the existing structure in the space.
One of my projects in Bangkok was to create a garden on a hospital roof. It was built on the old helipad. Instead of ripping off something that was old or abandoned, we can incorporate it into a new project.
At home, we can start small. Why don't we start in our kitchen? It is so powerful. Think about organic waste that we all produce each day. And remember, all the waste that we produce will increase 70% in 2050 if we're not doing anything about it now. That's actually the most important message I want to say to all of you today.
The U.S. Justice Ruth Ginsburg once said, do something outside ourselves, something to repair tears in our community. We are all confronting this climate uncertainty together, but there would always be some people who are more vulnerable than others. People across the world will be displaced. Some will lose their homes and loved ones to climate tragedies. Share your solution and let's fix the climate change through building a just society. So my final message to all of us is don't fix nature, fix ourselves. We have to be a better job to create a better city, take more responsibility, take more action so that our home, our city, can once again live with nature. Thank you.